Allora, è già finito.
Good morning, everyone. As I said during the opening of the event, the first edition of this symposium was a great success. One of the main responsible for this was Professor Francesco Mainardi. He was supervised by Professor Caputo and is by his side as one of the greatest in the history of fractional calculus. Professor, we would like to be with you in person to show you the natural beauties and gastronomic wealth of our region. But since we cannot, we are very happy with your virtual presence here with us. Thank you so much for giving us, once again, the honor and joy of attending our event. The word is yours, Professor Mainardi.
Thank you very much. I hope to start. Slide one, okay. As you see, I changed the title because I have added some old aspects, because more novel aspects will be treated, dealt by my colleague Arappa. Yes, in practice, okay, before I would like to thank the organizers. It is for me the third time I am in Brazil, but nowadays only on internet, sorry. The research has been carried out in my project about fractional calculus modeling. The abstract is the following one. I deal at the beginning with the right function, which are not so well known in the literature of special functions. More famous are surely the Whittaker function, because are treated in any book, any book. Anyway, the right function play a fundamental role in fractional diffusion, so that in fractional calculus modeling. But Whittaker function are related with the right function in some special cases. The contents is here. Before, in two sections, I will speak about the right function, which are well known, at least I presume, in fractional calculus. Then I introduce Whittaker function, which in some sense were new to me, but they are described in any handbook of special functions. So then, with the help of my colleague Paris, I connected them with the right function. And the main point is the Laplace transform, which is expressed in terms of the right function, and so that in practice also with Whittaker function. I put two appendices if there is time. Okay, I will recall what is the classical right function is here. It's practically very similar to the Mittag-Leffler function, but there is this factorial here, and this is the integral representation. But as the Mittag-Leffler function is an entire function, but lambda can be also negative, cioè the first parameters. Instead, in the Mittag-Leffler, the first parameters is not negative, or better, positive. Okay, here I forgot some interrogation match, I didn't remember more, but anyway, Wright introduced this function in the partition theory, and for lambda positive, not negative. But then in 1940, he considered also negative. I learned this from the Batman project, where probably for a misprint, lambda was not negative, was not considered in a negative part. So that when I introduced this function, I was in good faith, because I thought to have invented a new function, because I proved as an exercise for students that is entire. But it was made also by Wright in 1940, but not reported officially in the handbook, which was the main source, the only source of my problem. So that I prefer to divide the write function in two kinds. The first kind, which has the first parameters not negative, and the second kind, negative, between minus one and zero. And these are treated also in other place, in other papers by Wong, Zhao, and Paris, which are well-known specialists of special function. Okay, what is the relation with the Mittag-Leffler function? Well, it's a Laplace transform. In any book, you find this relation. But this relation is valid only for lambda not negative. For lambda negative, instead, we have this. This was practically my own result, which was shared also by Luchko and others in the paper by Orenflo, Luchko, Mainardi. But it is not well known, but it's very important, this fact, because when lambda is negative, the write function is no longer of exponential type, so that it cannot be inverted term by term. So that I found a method to find the correct relation, but for negative argument. About Mittag-Leffler function, I presume it is well known nowadays. And with an idea of Gorenflo and Kilbas, who are unfortunately dead, we made with Rogozin the second edition of this book. The first edition is 2014, but in the second edition we have added a chapter on the write function because are so well related with Mittag-Leffler function. Okay, what I made in 93 practically as an exercise, because I tried to solve the time fraction diffusion equation, and I used two auxiliary functions which I call with my initial name, because I did not find in the literature this function, but of course are special case of the write function, and the relation is between this one. W is the write function. Of course, in the literature, W is used as a Whittaker function, but because are more important in fractional calculus, we use the italic letter for the Whittaker function. The same problem for the Mittag-Leffler, because for the Mittag-Leffler, you see here, no, sorry, that does go, no, I don't understand why the file go up instead of go back. This make confusion. I'm sorry, but I cannot understand this change of order. No. If I go down, allora I go later. No. I cannot go. Why? I didn't understand. First page. No. Home page. No, that I don't understand this system. In Zoom, I share the video. The video is the following. I go back here. Why it go up? Is out of my control. I cannot know this, sorry. But if the computer make opposite, I cannot work. I cannot work on this condition. Sorry, but I cannot understand. Well, I cannot professor, understand.
Professor, usually the slide is yours. You are sharing your screen. Well, as we can see here, you are on page 41 and moving forward on your own presentation. No. 43, if you...
No. Put me in page 4.
In page 4?
Put you.
I'll try to do it for you.
Oh, yes, but why? Why I cannot manage by myself?
I really don't know. But
yeah, this is a mystery, of this system. Zoom is different.
Yes. Well, I don't know. It's a little bit weird. Are you trying to move some?
Page 4.
I'm trying.
If you like, you can put by yourself. If you put by yourself, I describe the slides. Probably it's better. Okay.
Yes, I don't know what's happening here.
This is the page I see.
Yes. I'm trying to change the slide because I can try to go to page 4, but it keeps on moving by itself. Here, slide 4.
Yeah. Then, I repeat, these are the write function, okay? Okay. These are the write function are divided in two kinds. Lambda positive, lambda non-negative, and lambda negative. For lambda positive or negative, better, the Laplace transform is related to this Mittag-Leffler function. But when lambda is negative, the Laplace transform, when the argument is negative, you see, and you put here lambda we call minus nu, is this Mittag-Leffler function. Why the reason? The reason that because the right function is no longer an exponential function, is not correct according to the book by Deutsch, so the Bible of Laplace transform, is not possible to invert term by term. So that I have to use the integral representation. Okay, the Mittag-Leffler function is well known nowadays, is no longer the Cinderella function, is no longer is known very well. Okay, and we made a book, second edition. Okay, now what is the most important right function for fractional diffusion? Surely these two functions, which I defined in 93, are the fundamental solution of two fundamental solutions of two boundary value problem of the right of the time fraction diffusion equation. These are the expression in terms of series, our entire function, I remember. And this is the integral representation. Now, some explicit representation. Up to now, I was able to find 1/2 and 1/3, but other people, like Aniga, like Riemert, found a relation with the Airy function. But Airy function are special case of Whittaker function, of a hypergeometric function. So that I have the suspect that at least for some rational order, the M right function, which is a particular type of right function, are related to Whittaker. And this was made in this talk by using the help of Professor Parrish and my student who makes the plots. This is also another expression which we find also before in our paper with Appelblatt. We found the story about this, which is before Aniga. In fact, it is very simple to say that when you make something in special function, you are almost sure that someone has already made before you. This because we had a lot of big scientists working in this topic. So that is quite difficult to be original in the theory. Probably we can be original in the application, of course. Okay. Also with Tomirotti, we made the asymptotic expression, which we see that this function decay as a stretched exponential. So that has a finite moment. Okay, these are the expression of this function, you see, in the X domain, and you see that only for X positive is positive. For X negative is can be negative, so as some zeros. But you find it is also in the paper by Luchko. But when lambda, when a parameter is between 1/2 and 1, is always positive. It encloses the Gaussian. and reduce to the delta function. Because this is the main point of this function, because it generalizes in some sense the Gaussian and the delta function, which play a fundamental role in partial differential equation of diffusion and wave propagation. Well, in fact, now I go back to the time fractional diffusion equation, where the fractional derivative is only in the Caputo sense, which is the most important for initial boundary condition, and all in time. And the order is between 0 and 2. When bit is 1, we have the diffusion equation. And when bit equal 2, we have the D'Alembert equation. And this we can see also here in integral form. Integral form is very important because you can understand how many initial conditions you need. Because if you have here one first derivative, you need one condition. But here we have the second derivative, so that we have you need two initial conditions. This is much more clear than in the differential form. Then, for simplicity, we introduce new the parameters, which is bit divided by 2, so that we go back to our original approach of right function, where we have a parameters between 0 and 1. In this case, ni go to 1, but you see that go to the delta function, which is no longer a function, so that everything is okay. What are the problem? Okay, are the Cauchy problem, of course, which are this one, which the initial condition is expressed in terms of x, and the world domain is considered. But you can consider also half domain, but a signaling problem. So that you give the initial condition only for t equals 0. And then are this one for x equals 0. And at infinity, 0. 0 are always, because are called the radiation condition. So that we have to solve this condition. These conditions are well known in the diffusion equation and wave equation. And for me, it was an exercise of mathematical physics for my students to consider this when the derivative is on time. The derivative, a fractional derivative is on time, which was new, at least in 93. Okay, and of course we need two conditions for this, and you put 0 in order to have a continuous transition. Okay, what do you find? In Laplace transform, yes, we find this for the Cauchy problem is right C. For the signaling problem, this one are related, you see, we have always the same exponential, but it's different the factor in front. Okay, and then we discover this reciprocity relation, which is generalized that one we find for the diffusion equation. Probably it's not so well known, but it's not difficult to derive this for the standard diffusion equation. And in Appendix A, I made this, but this for students. For people who are interested in fractional calculus, yes, we found this relation, which we found the enter of nu. When nu is 1/2, you get the usual. And when nu is 1, you find the usual diffusion equation. So that, what you get? Inverting the Laplace transform. We get for the Cauchy problem the M of right function, which generalizes the Gaussian. Okay? Instead, for the signaling, yes, and in signaling problem, we have again terms in terms of the M of right function, and in the standard diffusion equation, we have no longer the Gaussian, but this, which has a name in probability density, but anyway, is related to the Gaussian. But it's not the Gaussian, of course, because the Gaussian is this one, which has the second moment proportional to time according to the Brownian motion. Okay, I would like to see here the symmetric Weberite function. But this is very important because in the symmetric we have the transition and from diffusion to waves. And this seemed to me it was made also a simulation. I have the file later because now it's difficult to change file, in my opinion. But anyway, here is the expression. When u is between 0 and 1, we have exponential e minus x up to the Gaussian. Then we have the Gaussian split down in two, in a function which is no longer as two maxima, which and these go up to the two delta function. We are the fundamental solution of the Cauchy problem for the standard D'Alembert equation. So that the Weberite function is a natural generalization of two classical partial differential equations which are known by any student in applied mathematics. What are the Weitaker function? Well, we repeat what I said before about the relation of the Weberite function in some special case, in terms of the exponential, in terms of the Gaussian, and in terms for one third and two third for the Airy function. But Airy function are Weitaker function. So that it is natural to think that when the order is related to one third, probably we have the Weitaker function. Of course, I used some result already published by Paris and Vinogranov, where they found the relation of when u is one fourth, one third, one half, two thirds, three fourths, a relation between the right function, which I call of the second kind, with the Weitaker function. So that it was natural to me to involve Professor Paris to help me to solve this problem. Okay, what is the Weitaker function? Well, in any book, you can learn that Weitaker in 1903, so that much before Wright, wrote a differential equation, which solution are the Weitaker function, which takes the name after Weitaker himself. But I use the italic term, italic, because not make a confusion with the Wright. Of course, the same problem is the Mittag-Leffler, because before E is used for the integral exponential function, but now it's better to use E for Mittag-Leffler. Vabbè, but this is a question that the letter of alphabet are limited, so that we have this problem. But because E is an equation of second order, we have two independent solution, two independent solution, which are here. And you can see the Bible of special function nowadays is no longer the Batman project, but is the NIST project, where unfortunately, I don't know why, the Mittag-Leffler function is completely ignored, at least only one page. We devote for Mittag-Leffler one book, just because some people have a prejudice about fractional calculus. But I know we are in different frame nowadays, here at least. But you know that also nowadays there are people who do not trust in fractional calculus. We know also people who are against vaccines. Okay, you know, the life is good because it's various, and people can think what they like. Okay, so that we discovered, at least Paris told to me, that don't use the Weitaker function when the argument is negative, like for the logarithmic, where we have a problem, we have the branch cut, so that the number, the solution is negative. But before I found people like Stankovic and Humbert, they use Weitaker function with negative argument. So that I did not know why. Probably they did not know, show the proof in any case. In any case, we have to correct these errors. because it's like to write a logarithmic of negative argument, which is real. No, it's complex. No problem. Okay, and in fact, Stankovich was a great mathematician, but basing also on Humbert's paper, yes, he wrote these terms, which of course is nonsense, because it's like to write the logarithmic with a negative argument. This term is not real, it's complex. Instead, this function is real, okay? Ecco. And we, in good faith, also you put this formula in our book, because we trust in Stankovich. But unfortunately, any people, like also Newton, make errors. It's problem. No, nobody is infallible, okay? Also Nobel Prize, of course. Okay, so that we found from Parish-Vinogradov this condition, okay? And my student was able to plot the two terms and see they coincide. So that these are analytical proofs, but only numerical proofs, because it is easy when you write in LaTeX to make misprints. But this is a necessary condition. If the numerical numbers came, yes, and you see are correct. So that no problem. These are correct. And they were also proved in appendices, because Parish is a good mathematician and everything he writes, he proves. Okay, now we correct the Stankovich terms and we get this. You see, now, and in fact, this is a correct plot. Because this is the main results of these slides. Then, the special evaluation are here in this section, but nowadays the time go up. But anyway, these are the expression proved by Parish, and you see, we checked only the relation numerically, only the relation which I used the plots. Ecco, this one was checked. This one was checked numerically. You see a lot of relation between right in the left and Whittaker to the right. In some place you use the confluent, the imperiometric function, because but here is very here, yes. But nowadays I would like to call a relation which I used in 93, or better, I have to confess I used also in 1975, because when I was in Cambridge with Peter Buchan, we have to invert this Laplace transform, but we are not aware of the right function at that time. And in fact, I have to confess, I was aware of the right function only in 93, okay? Because they are disregarded in the Button project, but at least there is a chapter on miscellaneous function. But in any other book, no, nothing at all. Why? I don't know why, because especially to special function would consider also only every function, also the other function like Volterra function, for example. Why the book don't treat Volterra function? Volterra was an eminent mathematician, but you find this only in Appel book. Why? I didn't understand this prejudice about special functions. Okay, and now this the proof of this relation, of course, can be made from formally way, or also is in a rigorous way. In any case, it's correct. So that if it is correct, also if the method is formal, is a problem of mathematicians, of course. We are not a mathematician here. So here I would like to have a formula which are plottable. And plottable, it means they exist without errors. Okay, and now I found a a relation with the so-called three sisters. So that this equation, this, when in 93 I tried to invert this, I found in the table only when nu is 1/2. Why? Because 1/2 is a case of diffusion equation. But because I generalized the diffusion equation, I need different from 1/2. And where I found? I found from myself, of course, because in any table there is no present. This was our problem in 1975. Why you invert this, which in a table is not present? We can make by ourselves. Okay. So that when the nu is 1/2, we saw in the book by Desch, for example, where there is a specialist of Laplace transform, you find three functions which are related. This called, I called here, three sisters. Of course, when nu is 1/2 and nu is 1 minus nu, 1/2, nu and 1/2 are equal. So that we have four sisters. Okay. And now my student makes these the plots in his thesis. These are the three sisters, which are known in any book of diffusion equation. But I related these three functions with the Wright function. Okay, now I know the Wright function, so that I can express error and Gaussian function also in the Wright function. But always with two parameters, not many parameters. And the plot are the following, and these are in the thesis, master thesis, not master, bachelor thesis of Consiglio, because he's a student of the third year of physics. Of course, for four sisters, we have this. Anyway, you can look better in any paper of mine. Humbert, in 1945, during the World War, he wrote a paper in Laplace transform, because Humbert was a big man, a big scientist in Laplace transform, forgotten because in that period France was dominated by other troubles, than the Laplace transform, you know better, that there was a World War. But anyway, he wrote this equation. This equation in terms of Whittaker function, but without proof, but with negative argument. So that Paris said, but no, this equation it should be wrong, because Whittaker function is complex, is negative argument. So that we found the correct version, which is this one. Unfortunately, the plot is here. Ecco qua. The plot is the correct plot by student Consiglio, who was asked to verify every equation. Yes, and it's very important. I would like to stress here, in spite of other thought of our eminent scientist, that a function exists if it is plottable. Because if it is plottable, you see the function. Instead, if you write the function in terms of a series, of an integral, what means? I am a physicist and I like to see the function. This is my thing. Of course, I know that in the appendix, I repeat as a student, for students, the Laplace, ordinary diffusion equation, the standard diffusion equation. Yes, yes, here, and of course, I repeat what you got, the green function, the Cauchy signaling problem, and this is just for students. But you can understand, you can put there the function f and m, if you like. Of course, without nu, because r is this. So that I was inspired, you know, when I taught the diffusion equation to my student in 90, yes, I said, why don't generalize the standard diffusion equation in fractional case or in non-integer case? Why? In that time, rational calculus was forbidden practically. Nowadays, it's too much inflation. But anyway, no problem. The rational calculus has a good basis because we know that Abel, who much more than Abel, can be considered in mathematics. Nobody. If Abel has considered rational calculus, nobody cannot say anything about rational calculus because it was made by Abel, Riemann, and so on. So that nowadays, probably many things are wrong or unuseful, but anyway, is well based. But anyway, I cannot say here because here everybody is interested in rational calculus. Yes. And the plot are already made. Ecco, it is what I made for students, a relation between these two, so that are called three sisters, because you have to know only one, because playing with Laplace transform, you can get the other one. Here is expressed on, as an exercise. But but I would like to stress this, how to get equation B1. Allora, we can get one justification formal, which in practical was used also by Buch and Mainardi in 75 without knowing the right function. So to invert this, but this is not legal, at least for people who consider the standard Laplace transform. Yes, but Deitch treated also the Laplace transform of this type, which, of course, is not considered in the usual theory of Laplace transform, because you know that Laplace transform has to go to zero for s tending to infinity. And s alpha is integer, is a delta function, which, of course, is not to be used because it's not a function. Okay, you know, but in physics, a delta function is very important. Dirac, you know, that after 30 years, mathematicians were able to consider the delta function. Of course, you can call distribution, you can call general distribution, but it is always a function which is very important. Okay, and Deitch used the trick of Adamard finite part. So that he said, yes, we can use this, but accepting in t equals zero, because t equals zero, the function is infinite. Okay. Adamard is a very well-known mathematician, so that we trust in Adamard. Why not? And I trust in Deitch. Why not? So that, and this practically generalizes this function, which is valid only for alpha greater than minus one in the standard theory. But we can generalize, which, but if you like to make rigorous way, so that formally it is one. But we can use also a rigorous proof. And this was made by also by myself in 93. Because I discovered that the right function are entire also for negative lambda, yes, I used the reciprocal of the gamma function. The reciprocal gamma function is a very good result, which also called by Stefania in his, I presume, lecture notes in rational calculus. So gamma function is very important, and also is reciprocal, which is an entire function. This is very important. Because non-nut poles are only a branch point as infinity. Okay, now you take this equation as true, yes, and then when you make, deform, hope is possible, the Bromwich pass to Ankel pass, because vediamo se go back. Ah no, va sempre avanti. Okay, sorry. I am accustomed to go to use my my slides, but okay. Anyway, I used, I cannot back, unfortunately, back to my slides, but I used the gamma function in reciprocal, and then I got the result in a rigorous way. You can find these in my papers. Look, I show here Ecco, this was a fest just to make my priority. It was made in 93 in Bologna, but the paper was rejected, completely rejected in a journal, because they found, what is this? This everybody can make an exercise in a linear case. It's not a question of mathematical physics. Okay. Yes, then it became this paper, published 3 years later, was the most paper published by myself. Any case, I put this also in my notes of, yes, you can find here anything in this book, in these papers. Some are also free available in a print. So that if you look in Mainardi, in a print, you find a lot of papers where I can better understand my talk, because I'm a lot of confusing. Yes, let me see. I ask to the chairman to go to the simulation of Consiglio. Can I do?
Of course, Professor.
I finished my confused presentation as I expected, because I know or Zoom or other, I can make a confusion because I'm late. You know, I am close to 8 years old, so that, you know, that I cannot manage.
Professor, do not worry. The presentation was great.
Well, if you say, I don't think so, but anyway, it's the same. Let me share the video.
For sure. It's possible. It's possible. Just go to the video. Would you like to present the video right now? Do you have the video?
Yes, I would like to present the simulation of the passage, the simulation of the right function go from exponential to Gaussian to delta function.
Which is using YouTube. Nice. Do you have the video to play?
Yes, I have. But I have to share the video.
Yes, just go right here where you have the icon. Microphone, camera. Share. Go to the share one and then put the video. There is an option to introduce the video.
Can I share?
Sure.
Can I share here? Share the screen. I can.
Well, or you share the screen, or you share the video.
I try to share the video.
Sure.
I'm sorry. Terrible. Too difficult for me. No, but the screen is MP. Is MP, it's a shame.
Yes, let me try to...
I send you by email? No, I don't know. It's too difficult. Too difficult to understand.
Well, first of all, try to stop the showing your presentation.
Yes.
Stop showing this one, and then we may try to introduce the video. It's probably an icon here saying stop sharing or something like that.
Yes, should be the share. As I shared the presentation, I can share also a MP file. Why not?
Yes, for sure. And if you want, you can try to share your whole screen.
I propose I will send you, and then you show when I will give my tribute to Machado Friday. Yes, I can show also this video. Okay. You can show this video better. You.
Yes, instead of showing the video during the presentation to Professor Terreiro Machado, I'll let the video here in our YouTube channel.
Understand. he understands the English.
Well, we have some questions for you, Professor. Can I show them?
Yeah, better, better. Good. I try to reply, because please speak slowly, because my English is poor, and also I don't, I have other trouble.
Instead of reading to you, I'll just present the questions here, so you feel free to read them and then talk. I guess it's going to be better.
Yes,
the first one, I would not try to read, because it's from Professor Edmundo, and it's in Italian. Can you see it?
Beh, Cappella's write in Italian, so that I can understand. But it would be better to write in English, so that people can understand. Yes,
the next question is from Edmundo, and he wrote in English. Just only one question. Whittaker function is a particular confluent hypergeometric function.
I try to reply. Unfortunately, I'm not so expert of confluent hypergeometric functions, but I try now, with help of Paris, to understand them overall, because I am a fan of trichomy. For me, trichomy is my maestro. In practice, I never met him, but I have also a sentence of him who like to be simple as possible. Overall, on things, simple things. Anyway, trichomy function is a special case of a hypergeometric function, and I try to involve also Cappella's on this problem, but for me the main source is Paris, because Paris has wrote a chapter in the NIST project about confluent hypergeometric functions, and trichomy is no longer in life. This is the main problem.
Okay. Just a comment from Edmundo. Thank you for participating in the symposium. And let me go to the next one. There are several comments thanking you for the presentation. And now I'll show the question from José Vanteller.
Also here I have to look. May I suggest to look in the NIST project? It's a chapter on hypergeometric function. Because in the NIST project, there are also plots. It was made in recent years by a group directed by Olver, so that any eminent scientist like my good friend Nico Temme, you can see a lot of plots and applications, so that surely you can get the reply to your question. Of course, you are right. The relation with the Mittag-Leffler function is not treated at all, so that this could be an open problem. Because unfortunately, in that NIST project, I remember when someone presented the NIST project in Santander in Spain in 2005 for the occasion of the retirement of Nico Temme, I put my hands and I said, "Why you don't use Mittag-Leffler function?" And he replied, "It's very cumbersome." "But why it's very cumbersome? It's only one parameter." H function, I know, are cumbersome, but not Mittag-Leffler function. No, it's a prejudice. It's a prejudice. And if you look in this project, there is also one page and related to the right function, but right function as a generalized Bessel function. Okay, Bessel function, okay, no problem, are very important. But Mittag-Leffler function is very important. Why not? I didn't understand this prejudice. I did not understand. It's very simple. Is a realization of the exponential more simple than this? What you find? Write function is more little cumbersome, if you like, because I have one parameter more. But Mittag-Leffler, of course, well, now you have Mittag-Leffler in n parameters, of course. You can look in the book by Kiryakov, and you find also n parameters. Problem is to find the application, but up to three parameters in the Prabhakar function, you can see the review by Giusti et al. Also, there is also my name. You find a lot of application because in physics we work on one, two, three parameters. When the parameters are more, it's more difficult. It's impossible to fit a graph with more than three parameters, at least for me.
Well, that's why some people used to call Mittag-Leffler function as the queen of the special functions.
Yeah. I had the honor and the privilege to call this function as the queen function of the Frasional calculus. And someone told to me, no, the queen function is H function. Why? Okay, H function include every function, also with Tucker, of course. But you can also ask the God. The God is already more. Okay. I look to work in the particular case. Particular case, for me, it is enough Mittag-Leffler in one, two parameters, and sometimes also in three parameters. Why not? Why not? But more than three parameters for me is impossible. I cannot see. Like to work in a dimension of then more three. Okay, theoretical physicists work in dimension of 10. Okay, but not in the real life. Cioè, in real life, you see, you live in the three dimension, no more dimension. Three plus time, surely.
Well, before I introduce the next question, I would like to read what Professor Felix Silva told. First of all, thank you for your participation in the symposium. Everyone here today recognize that your contributions are fundamental for fractional calculus to grow exponentially. Well, maybe not exponentially, but according to a Mittag-Leffler function.
No, but this is dangerous because, if you know something like the Heisenberg inequality, the quantity is inverse proportional to the quality. When there are many papers, yes, now you can see. If you look, for example, in the symposium, which is in these days in Turkish, you see more than 100 presentations on fractional calculus. Are you sure that all 100 presentations are good? I don't think so. Too many.
Well, but the question from Felix Silva is this one. I have one question. Being the function of Mittag-Leffler, the queen function,
for me, a queen is only one in my life. Then, okay.
Great. And let me see.
I am a conservative. I am conservative. Like the British people. God save the queen. God save the Mittag-Leffler function.
Great, professor. And there are some other things. Professor Luis Roberto Evangelista,
he's a good friend of mine. He's a good friend of mine because he's an Italo-Brasiliano, and he speaks Italian. And I hope he will come to Bologna in spring. He's from Torino, so that he's in Italy now.
Next one, Carla Pinto, one of our main exposers, saying always a pleasure to have you here. Edmundo would like to thank you for the questions, and I'm not trying to translate this one. A message for the organization.
No, it's not true that Whittaker is a trigonometry function. Trigonometry function is more general. No problem with this. Whittaker function is a particular confluent hypergeometric function. Instead, it's similar to say Mittag-Leffler function is a H function. Yes, it's true. but Mittag Leffler has considered separately. So you have to not consider the particular case with a general case, in my opinion.
Well, Professor, now we are going to have the virtual coffee break. I would like to thank you once and again. It's always a pleasure to have you here with us. The first edition, you were one of the main responsible for the great success we had.
A question. Allora, Friday, tell me, because I did not know this fact, I can present my tribute to the late Professor Massado 5 minutes, so 5 minutes only. Ten minutes.
No problem. You can send the video to me, okay? But let me, first of all, finish the presentation, then we keep on talking. Pessoal, vou encerrar aqui a transmissão do professor Francisco Mainardi. Professor, thank you very much. And I would like to invite everyone to see the next presentation, which is going to be presented by Professor Roberto Garapa. And we will start, I guess, 10 and a half. See you there.
Thank you very much.